Hey, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. Today's an exciting day. We just got the new Chins 12.8 volt, 100 amp hour, low temperature heating, smart lithium iron phosphate, deep cycle battery. And this looks to be a game changer. Everything about this is pretty cool. So let's get right into it. So depending on what part of the country you live in or part of the world, a lot of people in colder climates, the lithium iron phosphate battery can be a little bit of a challenge in colder climates, and you have to keep your battery storage room heated and keep your batteries at a certain temperature in order to charge them properly. So Chins has eliminated that problem by adding a heating element that when the temperature in the battery drops below 32 degrees, all power will go to the heating element inside the battery and keep it warming up until it reaches 50 degrees, and then it will open up whatever you're charging with, solar panels, charger, whatever. It'll open that back up to fully charge your battery. So it makes sure that it's at the right temperature, so you don't damage your battery by trying to charge these in cold weather. So the other very cool thing about this is it has a Bluetooth app. So this almost completely eliminates the need for a battery monitor. And if you watch some of my earlier videos, you can see, like on my other battery bank, that's what I'm working on installing now because it is not a smart battery like this one. So I'm having to apply a separate battery monitor on it to know exactly the state of charge. But on this one, as you can see, right now it's reading 13.1 volts. It's at 28%. I've been doing a slow discharge. I'm going to discharge it all the way to zero for the first time and then charge it back up as per Chin's recommendations on how to initiate use of one of these batteries. So, of course, 100 amp hour capacity. Slide it over. It shows the same thing in a kind of a dial, 13.1 volts. But here's what's also really nice about this. It shows the current being drawn on it. Currently, I have that little 12 volt Bestech inverter hooked up to it, and I've been running some smaller appliances off of it just to help drain this down. But just with the inverter on itself, it shows 0.7 amps of current being drawn. It shows the temperature of the battery, 75.2 degrees Fahrenheit or 24 degrees Celsius. And then the last display that it has on this monitoring app is each individual cell of the four cells in here. Each cell, it shows the current voltage. It shows it is in discharge mode right now. And you can see cell number one. I hope you can see this adequately. Cell one, 3.273. Cell two, 3.272. Cell three, 3.277. Cell four, 3.273 volts. So it shows you what each individual cell is at just a quick glance on your phone. This is a great feature, and like I said, I wouldn't even need to hook up a battery monitor to this particular battery, and I don't plan on it since I can monitor it with the phone. So in the parameters it shows in their introduction booklet for this particular model, it is the charge voltage 14.2 to 14.6. So when you're setting your charge control parameters, set it within that range. I currently, on my other Chins battery, set it at 14.2. It's working perfectly. There's really no amperage for me to be gained after 14.2 anyway. The other really incredible thing about this is how lightweight it is. Comes in at 24 pounds. So it's a real featherweight as far as batteries go. And the maximum continuous charging current is 50 amps. Maximum continuous discharging current, 100 amps. Max load inverter power, if you were just only using one battery, is 1,000 watts. So you could tie several of these in parallel or series, depending on your needs. These are just the specifications for one single battery. So once again, Chins really came through, knocking one out of the park with this model. A smart battery for all of us that don't want to have to be glued to the monitor. Anytime you have the urge, you can just flip on your phone and take a peek and see what you're doing. And that is just so fantastic. I can't tell you what a nice thing this is. I've talked with a lot of you out there that own this battery. You're all having a very parallel experience to mine. Chins is an excellent company to deal with. They're putting out an excellent product at a fair price, and they back their product. So I just couldn't be happier with this company. I've talked with their customer service many times over the past many months, always very willing and helpful to do what is ever necessary to make sure I'm operating this the way it was intended. These things just, knock the tripod down a little bit, but anyway, this right here, I'll tell you, so very cool. At a glance, everything. Now, where I live here in the tropics, I don't really have to be too concerned about this low temperature heating unless I was to go camping into higher elevation and take this, which is always a possibility. Then I never have to worry about what the temperature, the ambient temperature is, because this battery is going to take care of itself. And as usual, this thing was shipped out here from the mainland. It arrived in pristine condition. Their packaging is excellent. So, you know, from the point of view of the durability, and I'm just kind of at loss of words for this, actually, at the moment. Pretty exciting little unit. I'm going to plug in a small device here and then show you on the monitor how accurate it is at drawing. I can tell you it's very accurate, like right now. In fact, with that inverter running, it's just in idle mode, but it's drawing 0.7 amps. And that's exactly what that thing is running in idle mode. But let me throw a small load on it so you can see how that handles it.
What's it say?
Okay, so let's plug in a little coffee grinder to this. And you'll have to forgive the noise, but I'm going to give it a go and then I'll see what the monitor goes up to. So it jumped from 0.7 amps to where it's now drawing 7.6 amps. This isn't as big of a load as this battery can handle, but it just shows you how accurate that is. And that's about dead accurate, because this thing draws about 7 amps. The inverter we know draws about 0.7 amps. So right there it is. And like I said, I'm going to go ahead, like Chins recommends, draw this down to zero, charge it all the way back up, and then just put it in use and let it cycle throughout the day on solar. And one of the last things I'll say here is that this thing, when it arrived at 13.11 volts, and it was registering that as a 45% charge. So I've had this thing all night long with the inverter, and I was drawing a little ultraviolet light for my water purification, which if you've watched that video, you'll see that it's a very low power light, but even on all night long, barely touch this battery. So I'm gonna just let it keep slowly discharge until zero, charge it back up, and then we'll be putting it right into operation. So for all of you that have stuck by this channel and subscribed and support us, thank you very much. And for those of you that haven't, go ahead and subscribe. We'll keep you up to date on whatever content we're running across out here in the boondocks. All right. Thanks for watching, everybody. Aloha.